the government acknowledges the role of the taxpayer in the nation building. Each rupee of the tax contributes towards the government's effort to provide a better infrastructure, rural revival and social well-being. Taxation is a major tool to the government for removing poverty and inequality from the society. The prosperity will not forgive us if we do not use this opportunity in this perspective. The thrust of my tax proposals this year falls in 9 categories. 1, relief to small taxpayer. 2, measures to boost growth and employment generation. 3, incentivizing domestic value additions to help make in India. 4, measures for moving towards a pension society. 5, measures for promoting affordable housing. 6, additional resource mobilization for agriculture, rural economy and clean environment. 7, reducing litigation and providing certainty in taxation. 8, simplification and rationalization of taxation. 9, use of technology for creating accountability. Relief to small taxpayer. In order to lessen the burden on individuals with income not exceeding 5 lakhs, I propose the ceiling of tax rebate under Section 87A from 2000 to rupees 5000. There are more than 2 crore taxpayers in this category who will get a relief of rupees 3000 in their tax liability. The people who do not have any house of their own and do not get any house rent allowance from their employer today get a reduction of rupees 24000 per annum in their income to compensate them for the rent they pay. I propose to increase the limit of deduction in respect of rent paid under Section 80GG from rupees 24000 per annum to rupees 60000 per annum, which should provide relief to those who live in rented houses. The next, madam, is important. Presumptive taxation schemes under Section 44AD of the Income Tax Act is available for small and medium enterprises, that is non-corporate businesses, with a turnover or gross receipts not exceeding 1 crore rupees. At present, 33 lakh small business people avail of this scheme, which frees them from the burden of maintaining detailed books of account and getting audits done. I propose to increase the turnover limit under this scheme to rupees 2 crores, which will bring big relief to a category of assessees in the MSME category. That is to say, anyone with a turnover in business of 2 crores, there will be a presumptive income of 8%. I also propose to extend the presumptive income taxation scheme to all professionals with gross receipts up to 50 lakhs with a presumption of profit being 50% of their gross receipts. Madam, this for small businesses and all professionals, this will bring tremendous ease in their taxation matters. Measures to boost growth and employment generation. I had in my last budget speech mooted a proposal to reduce the rate of corporate tax from 30% to 25% over a period accompanied by rationalization of removal of various tax exemptions and incentives. In any case, the effective rate of tax paid by the companies comes to an average of 24.67 because of various exemptions which they are availing of. A phasing out plan of these exemptions and tax incentives was placed in the public domain. We have received a large number of constructive suggestions. The final phasing out of exemptions is given in an annexure to the speech. The highlights are as follows. The accelerated depreciation provided under the Income Tax Act will be limited to a maximum of 40% with effect from 1st April 2017. The benefit of deductions of research would be limited to 150% from 1st April 17 and 100% from 1st April 2020. The benefit of Section 10AA to a new SEZ will be available to units which commence activity before 31-3-2020. The weighted deduction under 35 CCD for a skill development will continue up to 1/4 2020. The reduction in corporate tax has to be calibrated with additional revenue expected from the incentives being phased out. The benefits of phasing out of exemptions are available to the government only gradually. In the first phase, therefore, I propose the following two changes in the corporate income tax rates. A, the new manufacturing companies which are incorporated on or after 1st March 2016, as proposed, to be given an option of being taxed at 25% per surcharge plus cess, provided they do not claim any profit-linked investment-linked deduction and do not avail of any investment allowance and accelerated depreciation. Madam, new manufacturing companies will also bring jobs. I also propose to lower the corporate income tax rate for the next financial year of relatively small enterprises companies with turnovers not exceeding 5 crores in the financial year ending March 2015 to 29% per surcharge plus cess. Startups generate employment, bringing innovation, and are expected to be key partners in Make in India program. I propose to assist their propagation through 100% deduction of profits for 3 out of the 5 years for startups set up during April 2016 to March 2019. MAT will apply in such cases. Capital gains will not be taxed if invested in regulated or notified fund of funds and by individuals in notified startups for which they hold majority shares. Research is a driver of innovation, and innovation provides a thrust to economic growth. I propose a special patent regime with 10% tax on income from worldwide exploitation of patents developed and registered in India. In order to get more investment in the asset reconstruction companies, which plays a very important role in the resolution of bad debts, I propose to provide a complete pass-through of income tax to securitization trusts, including trust of ARCs. The income will be taxed in the hands of the investor instead of the trust. However, trust will be able to deduct tax at source. The period for getting long-term capital gain regime in the case of unlisted companies is proposed to be reduced from 3 to 2 years. Non-banking financial companies will be eligible for deduction to the extent of 5% of their income in respect of provision for bad and doubtful debts. For determining the residency of foreign company on basis of place of effective management is proposed to be deferred by 1 year. I would like to reiterate our commitment to implement the general anti-avoidance rules from 1/4 2017. In order to meet our commitments to the BEPS initiative of the OECD and G20, the Finance Bill 2016 includes provisions for requirement of country-by-country reporting for companies with a consolidation revenue of more than euros 750.